My name's Mel. I'm one of the grade two teachers at Wooranna Park Primary. Previously, I studied at Deakin University, and in my final year of my degree, I was a student teacher here as well through a partnership program. This morning, I did a maths workshop. It was based on additive strategies, so using larger numbers that they're not used to working with, and how can they use the strategies that they use on smaller numbers and actually use that to solve that problem. So we introduced the idea of using resources, understanding that it's okay not to have all the answers in your head and to be able to lean on something else and use something else to help you. It's also looking at the differences between the students and how using that to inform further teaching as well. So my question for you is, have a look at the numbers. Got them down here. How are you going to work this out? We have some MAB. So you've got your longs.
This is a little bit easier.
Hundreds. Your ones.
And the tens.
And your hundreds. So these are the tens. You've got some unifix.
Lollipop sticks.
And you've also got some bundles. And some singles. And bicycle sticks. So I want you to think about it. I don't want you to talk about it with anyone because I want to know what you're thinking. What do you think you're going to use? How do you think you're going to work it out? I'm going to give you a minute to think about it. My students are very varied in ability. We've got some students that are working well below the standard that they should be at this time of year. We've also got students that are well above that standard. So one of the main things for me to concentrate on is how can I utilise that and make the most out of every lesson for every student. So how can I plan a lesson that's going to cater for those students and make sure that they still get something out of it despite whatever level they're at. My students are also very engaged when something's hands-on, so making sure they actually have something to manipulate, and that's where the use of resources can be very useful. A challenge for you. Can you work it out in a way that you can show me how you got the answer? Okay. So instead of trying to just use that very smart brain of yours, can you find a way that you can work it out so that you can show me what you're thinking about? Okay. It's really hard for a lot of teachers to decide on what students are understanding, what students are literally copying. So one thing with using resources and manipulatives such as the MAB blocks, the Unifix, and the IC pole sticks with bundles and separate sticks is that I can actually see what students are doing, the way they're laying the sticks out or the MAB blocks out. Are they trading them correctly? That can show me a lot about what they're thinking, what their thinking processes are, as to whether or not they're solving a problem or are they trying to apply an algorithm that they've memorised.
Taking them away. Yeah. This one. Now, is that easy to count?
At the end of the session, where students share which strategies they use, do help to open other students' eyes, and it gives chances for students to be able to model and actually teach other students, and that will help them to develop their own understanding as well. One thing with a lot of the students at a higher level is they seem to have this fixed idea that their idea is right, that nobody else knows, and therefore no one else can do it in any other way. And it's really good to have students sometimes at a lower level saying, I did it a different way and it worked. And starting to open these other kids' eyes up and go, oh, maybe I can think about it in a different way. Maybe I can do it in a different way. And maybe my way isn't the only way.
What else could we use, Rayla?
Well, I use the MA blocks for my
whole thing. So these ones?
Me too.
So that can look quite similar, can't it?
10,
20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. What are we going to use now, Liz?
No, that's 100.
These are small.
Yes.
Okay. Can you see that we've got one, two, three very different ways of doing it?
Using these
would have definitely got the answer. Yeah. So you can use lots of different resources. There's lots and lots of different ways to solve the same problem.